good morning to each and every one of you. Thank you so much for joining us on this holy Saturday. It is a Wake Up Like This with your host, Queen Lerner, and her special guest right here on Radio Belize Mix on this beautiful Saturday. Goodness gracious, Queen Lerner, how you doing this morning, Queen Lerner?
Doing fine.
You're looking fine.
I know,
Queen Lerner, you have a very special guest this morning. Will you? Do you care to introduce this queen?
Yes,
another queen?
Another queen is in the house today, you guys. We are so grateful to have her here with us today. It's been a while. She was with us maybe over 6 years ago. And Mr. Jansen says we gotta get her back, mm-hmm. because we only spent about 15 minutes with her. So today, guys, we have the lovely Belizean singer, songwriter, and 3 times female winner for female vocalist in the country of Belize, you guys. She have many hit songs, you know, and I'm going to tell you what, the Bully Queen is back. Mm-hmm. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a Wake Up Like This. Let's welcome Tanya Carter.
That's right. Welcome to the show.
Tanya Carter, how you doing? How you wake up, Tanya?
I woke up fabulous, darling. Fabulous. Man, you could give really good intros. I liked it. It's so nice. Feel good. Thank you.
Yes, you're welcome, gal. Where have you been and how are you and what's going on?
Everything go on, you know, back they hurt me, but I'm still alive, you know, found that gray hair, you know, things like that, you know, but here's the thing, you know, I'm just grateful for, you know, wanting to get back into music. I've been away for maybe 5 years, calling a couple things here and there just for like warm up and stuff like that, but I've been away for way too long, and I just decided this year, me and my team, that we wanted to come back with a newer, fresher, less angry Tanya.
Aye!
Less angry.
You hear that, guys?
Yeah.
Less angry, because that was something that I was going to ask her anyway, because I was, the message of her song, most of her songs, she have hit songs like Ex-boyfriend. I mean, these are messages she's sending out to somebody. You understand? Wishy-washy. I mean, Mr. DJ Boy, she's just crazy. She makes a million and she's just a bully. And, you know, all these songs have meaning behind it. So, Tanya, tell us, what's the message in most of these songs?
Oh my gosh. Well, you know, I don't want to just seem like I was just like toxic. That's not what I was trying to get at. It's just a lot of things happened to me, and it's so funny that when it comes to my personal life, it is very private, but a lot of bad stuff happened to me. I have no outlet. I had no way of getting it off my chest. So I decided to create somewhat of a diary in my music. And I'm really sorry that they come off a little bit, you know, yes, toxic, you know.
You was throwing the blows, girl. You was
I was. When I go back and I listen to Crazy, I cringe a little bit because I was damn near threatening him. Mm-hmm. And I said, wow. But, you know, I'm not there anymore per se. Like, you know, even although I still have a lot of music that I've written in that timeline, that span that I wasn't doing any music, and I look back to where I am now, some of my songs still need to be, I have to release them because it's just things that I've been through in that interim when
definitely.
I was doing music. So but I'm just a little bit more grown up.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, right. A little bit.
Let me tell them that she was not always crazy, guys, because we got some really great music that was meaningful, like the anthem, the national songs, you know, I Am Belize, and it, you know, so we got some real great meaningful songs out of her before she got into those punches and, you know, just tearing up the men and anybody that was in her way. Mr. Johnson, she even did a live performance where a police officer had her in handcuffs and she was performing.
I was watching one of the videos this morning, Miss Lerna, uh-huh. because you know I have to review the videos before I show them. I said, exactly. Lad, I can't come too close to Tanya Kawa. Run for cheating that joke.
I understand. Trust me. When I look back at it now, you know, it was honestly, it was just my story that I was telling and how I exactly. felt. Nice. And you know, one thing about me, this is something about me that is my Achilles heel, if you will. Mm-hmm. I'm going to tell you my business in my song. And you know, it's so therapeutic to me. Mm-hmm. You know, because when I look back at these songs and I think back of that ex-boyfriend that I had, I said to myself, I said, wow, I was so angry at him. I was so upset, but it's therapeutic to know that I got a hit out of it. If they turn a hit, you know, and even although that it probably, you know, even if I probably sitting right now, I would be like, you know, man, dodge a bullet. But
I wonder what he think about that song, which we're going to play in a minute as soon as she finish her thoughts. Go ahead.
Yeah, but I mean, honestly, you know, every one of them songs, even the ones that didn't become a hit per se, has mm-hmm. just made the catalog even bigger. And then it allowed me to just watch my growth. And I think that's the most inspiring thing to myself is I'm in competition with only myself.
Yes, sir.
And I look at me as that's it, because at the end of the day, being an artist is so hard. It's so hard. And I big up every single female, especially the females. It's hard for men too, but especially the females, because we have a lot to go through, more than a man, unfortunately. Mm-hmm. But it allows me to watch my consistent growth. And even in that spell that I wasn't doing any music, I think people will be very, very curious to know where I am going.
We're gonna touch that direction of your journey, uplifting in a second. But I want you guys to hear this song that she's talking about, the message of the song, and it just tore up the wave. She went to Jamaica. You went to Jamaica and worked on this special song, Ex-Boyfriend also. And so it was coming from a Belizean part of view, and then you got that straight Jamaican training from one of their producer there, right?
Yes.
And so, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take you back to her number one hit song, Ex-Boyfriend.
My ex-boyfriend.
Explore.
Belize's very own Tanya Carter on the microphone with the song called Ex-Boyfriend. Mercy, mercy me. Go ahead, Queen Erna.
Oh, wow. Ex-Boyfriend.
Mm-hmm.
That's an amazing video there, you Tanya. You guys did a hell of a job with that.
Thank you.
I know you were here explaining that particular song, Ex-Boyfriend, and how that came about.
Wait, Miss Lerna, I could brag just before you continue.
Brag.
I want to brag while you, but I think Tropical Sensation Band, my band, was the only band that ever played that song on a September Fest right here in Los Angeles, California.
And you know what, Tanya? That's something else that we definitely have to get to. The bands, they need to just start playing you guys' music because we don't hear it too much.
True.
You know?
True.
Yeah. So
at least the bands, when they're singing and when they're performing, because they're performing all over, they should incorporate this stuff that is hitting the nation. And so, I mean, I don't hear much of your song anymore. Like, they just said it.
But like I said, Queen Erna, I'm just bragging, but I pride myself in my group always playing the artist, Belizean artist music. Like, I play foreign music, I play Tanya music, I play Super G music. The band itself, I'm not talking about DJ, band.
Not the radio.
Yes, yeah. Yes.
The band. So that's something that we should try to push more often, Tanya. I think the responsibility is also on the artist to kind of touch bases with individual DJs or individual band and say, do you have my MP4, MP3 stuff? And just try to, let's have a relationship with each other so that the music can be, because I haven't heard this song until I'm doing my research now. You understand? So it's not in the memory. So congratulations on that. And that is a number one hit that we relate to you as.
Let me tell you something. You know something about that CMX boyfriend song, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Nobody know who that song about. Y'all, the ex-boyfriend, they be like, that song about me? And I go,
It could be the boyfriend when you was little, right?
I just left it up to that, you know.
Oh my goodness!
Very mysterious. I like the mystery about behind it.
Exactly. So you guys, they can find that music. All your music is on. Just tell them right now where they can find.
Spotify. You could find me anywhere online. I am Tanya Carter. On any of my platforms, and it goes straight into my YouTube, which is Tanya Carter on YouTube. So you can find it anywhere. Yeah.
Okay. And guys, Tanya is not just a artist, as you see, she is a writer. She take control of her music sense. I even saw somewhere where they said she is just a little hot mama. She take control with producers and making sure that and making sure that her music is what she want it to be, right, Tanya?
Right.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, because like it's like this, like I wasn't when I first started, oh my word, I wasn't the best when it comes to a lot of things. And I think when I got a little bit older, I started to just know exactly what I wanted. Mm-hmm. When I first started, I never knew. I've been in the music business for maybe like 23 years. And, I went to an art school. So I gone to Grace Chapel. So we were engulfed in music, dance, and anything with Panak. So that was our thing. So when it comes down to producers, I know what I want to hear. I know what I hear. I know how I want it sound. And I wasn't so good at them the feedback, but now, I've gotten way better with, giving the feedback.
Listen a little bit.
Music is ever evolving. And if we continue to think in our brains that no, this is the way how it sung and this is the way how it was sung, and we're gonna lose out on key followers, we're going to lose out on timeless music, and we're going to lose out on trending music. Like, for example, when Ex-Boyfriend came out, well, while we were writing Ex-Boyfriend, I remembered the producer did not like pieces of the song. And he was like, oh, why you said that? And why you said that? And I was like, and I told him verbatim, I said, because I am a girl. And I said, I don't know what girl like, because I am a girl. You know? And so, you know, the part where I did the, I can't believe this is happening to me, because it seems I can't get away from you. That part. He was like, nah, me not like it, only me not like it. Yeah. And I was like, it's fine. I said, but I do. I said, trust me, it's separating the song and letting the girl just roll with the music. And he was about to change it. And there was a girl that came in the studio that heard the song the night before, and she came in off beat and all, and she said, I can't believe this is
happening. And she sang that hook.
She sang that part. And so after that, he said, only be me give up. No way or the door.
It's so catching.
I was so grateful that he allowed me to just be very creative in that, you know, because, like, you know, Jamaicans tend for, they know what they want to hear. But he allowed me for put my Belizean thing on it, and it worked. It worked. Yeah.
Okay, before we get into, I know producer wants to throw in the newest and the latest and the comeback of the Bully Queen song right at this point. But before we get into that, I want to ask this question, because I know there's some questions and other people asking about it. You grew up with different style of music. You are a classical singer and opera. I mean, you grew up with all this style of music, and you jump into reggae. And I read somewhere where your first soca song, even though people were telling you you sound like Whitney Houston, or you are a Billie Jean Whitney Houston, you were determined to go the reggae way. Can you explain why that was your strength, and you said strongly, that's what I want to do instead of soca?
Well, I mean, honestly, like, when I first started, I didn't know my voice, and I didn't know what I had or what I sounded like, and I was mimicking. So every time I would hear Whitney Houston, I mimic Whitney Houston, and then I hear Christina Aguilera and I mimic her. And so I never had a voice per se. So it was just mimicking. I was just copying how they sound. Mm-hmm. And when I got to reggae, and there was this one guy who was a part of a whole band, shout out to, you know, Ken Doyle and Dane and of course, those guys. We just played anything, and we turned reggae. And I realized at that moment, I never have to sound like Whitney Houston. And I realized I never have to sound like Aline, and I didn't have to sound like this one. I was me.
That was me.
And then I made up a little ditty, and, you know, Paul, you know, did these like keys thing, and I was just like singing, and we made up a song, and I was like, that's the first time I felt free. And I never really looked back, even although that I might sing other things. You know, it took me a very, very long while to really feel that sense of independence when I jumped into reggae. And even although people, you know, they didn't like it at first, and I stopped it, and then it became very successful for me. So it's not the hottest genre right now. But reggae still is a big part of my upbringing. So I definitely have to give kudos for making my way, my path a little bit more clear.
And you were much in love with one of your biggest fans in that field, Dennis Brown. I think you're crazy about that particular.
Yes.
He's a nice.
Ultimate. I love, love, love Dennis Brown.
That means
oh my
Dennis
word.
Brown. Okay. So, but I just, this is what I want people to know. And this is what I'm trying to, on this platform, that with you guys out there, even though you're singing reggae and you know this, that's a tough competition because Belizean reggae and Jamaican and all those, I mean, they're up here. So yeah. You guys have to work very hard. And I just want people to know that that is not just what you do, especially you as one of Belize's most popular female artists, that you sing other genres of music.
Yes.
You understand? And she really does, and she blasts it, and maybe, you know, you guys need somebody needs to hear you sing, you know, like you did in one of the karaoke places that everybody turn around when you start throwing off, and it was not a reggae song. You mm-hmm. understand? So I just want folks to know we have Belize got talent and multi-talent, you know? So anyhow, we're gonna take it in right now. Before we take it to that new release, let me just big up our sponsors out there in this rain. Little Belize Restaurant there in Inglewood, we're open till 7. You guys give it up for sponsoring this platform. Also, Probis Tax and Accounting, you guys, for sponsoring this. Oh my goodness, it's tax time. You guys know it's tax time. All right, get over there, give her a call, and don't be late or put in an extension. All right, ladies and gentlemen, and also, if you are coming in town, Tanya, and you guys want to ride in style, we got the right transportation for you, and we're going to get you in town more often, you guys. We have Thurton Executive Transportation that we're working with, Dr. Tez and her husband. The transportation is here if you want to ride in style. Thurton Transportation. Give it up for Thurton Transportation. And, of course, the Mr. and Mrs. Radio Belize Mix. Of course, he goes up, down, in between, all over. He makes sure that we get a beautiful platform to promote, to spread the word, to educate. And where there's a will, how you say it, Will?
Where there's a will, there's a way.
There's a way. So I want to thank you guys. And you guys, this platform is, it's not free, but we are donating all this stuff so that we can help each other. You understand? So give it up for Radio Belize Mix, Miss Bev, and Mr. Johnson.
Thank you, thank you.
We appreciate you. All right, all right, all right. You guys know the team song, Mr. Michael Wagner. All right. Mm-hmm. All right, all right, all right. And who wants, Mr. Will, can you do me the honor of announcing the debut?
Oh my goodness gracious.
And Radio Belize Mix, not... even though she have it out there already, you guys, and it's hitting the nation. 83,000 views are going and going and going.
Yeah.
And yes, yes, yes.
Not too long ago she reached out to me, and I didn't know who I was talking to. I can't catch up afterwards. I like, I gotta box myself. I said, glad I catch up with Kashi, man. I don't mean while eating or two. I find out, oh, that Tanya, okay, Tanya said you have a brand new song. Oh, don't let me down. So I listened to it. I said, what a comeback.
Is that another message? Tanya.
Guilty.
Guilty. All right, don't let me down. Did you say it?
Let me down.
Guilty, guilty.
Now everybody, they look for a story like this. Cause boy, you don't get no better. No, we don't get no sweeter. No, I will never leave. And I promise you made, and I pray you will keep. Cause life, it don't get no easier. But if you keep it real, you will always have me. So sweet, boy, and you-
You saw my heart and then you win me right over.
Heart and then you win me right over.
You are my man, my shield, my soldier. Hey, and no matter where they try for say, nobody could ever keep my heart away. Your heart is safe and sound, they could have never missed wrong. So please don't let me down, no way.
Baby, don't let me down. Don't let me down.
You won't let me down, no.
Baby, don't let me down. Don't let me down.
Don't let me down.
Baby,
my goodness, I like that. I like that almost that baritone all the way underneath there. Like, oh my goodness, the lioness, the songstress, Tanya Carter. Go ahead, Queen Lerner.
All right, Tanya. I thought we said we was finishing with the blows, but anyhow, tell us a little bit about your direction you're heading. This is coming out after how many years?
Probably about five.
About five years.
Well, this one never that bad. I mean, you know, I'm just saying, you know, please don't let me down. And I know you won't, but don't. Please.
Mm-hmm. Please. That's it. You're begging this time.
Yeah. I come from a different position. No, I'm just begging. Hey, mm-hmm. Don't let me down. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Thank you. You know, you hear the growth. Mm-hmm. The growth.
So, I also heard a different genre coming into that. So you're headed into a different direction with your music. Can you tell us what you're doing there?
So I've teamed up with new producers, and I was very much interested in, I don't really work with Belizean producers, because I just never get them to use them. And I wanted, for this project, the project that I'm working on, I said, yo, I wanted Belizean producers. And at the forefront, I ended up with Boza, who I married to.
Oh, okay.
and he really, really loves getting into the whole Afro vibe, the Afrobeat vibe. Mm-hmm. And he teamed up along also with Supreme Leader, who is a from London, but he has Nigerian roots.
Okay. So
they did a lot of stuff together and just trying to get me on another wavelength, along with my reggae, along with, you know, so what they wanted me to do is to just play around with some sounds and put Creole on it. And I never thought about that. I thought that would have been like, you know, but it turns out that in Nigeria and lower parts of Africa, there is something very similar to how we talk, and it's called Pidgin. I didn't know.
Pidgin.
When I think I do my Creole thing, you know, whatever. And they were like, one guy come up to me and say, oh, this is so good. I can't believe you're speaking Pidgin. And I said, no, I'm not speaking Pidgin. I'm speaking Creole. But it's very, very similar.
Oh, okay.
So it's just another avenue for me to get out there and just wet my toes in at that area. And, you know, we never know. It might be good. It might be meh. But we did it anyway, and we just wanted to create some good music. That's my ultimate goal. Good music, still reggae, but just we're dabbing in our toes into Afrobeat now.
Oh, you hear that, Mr. Johnson? A new direction.
Yeah, and I'm loving it, actually. I'm loving it.
You're loving it?
Mm-hmm.
All right. So
she convinced me.
Huh?
She convinced me.
to convince you. All right, so Tanya Carter, I like how she say her name. Say your name, Tanya.
Tanya Carter.
Tanya Carter. She have a this thing with her tongue that she rolls. So Tanya, you know the whole shebang of the industry. And now I want you to send messages to upcoming artists out there, female artists, because you know the game, you know what to expect. And so basically I know you have a platform that you are really working the platform. You have many people on there. The music that you are doing, that's where you're pushing, along with everyone that is supportive, you guys. We want female artists. Every time I turn around, I'm seeing male artists performing. Male artists is all on the bill. I don't see my female artists. So at this point, if you're a female artist, I need you guys to check in so that we can get our face. I'm not the singer, but so we could get our faces out there. Because a couple of weeks ago, I saw something and I said, where is my female artist? You understand? So guys, we're going to take a music break so you guys could warm up a little bit. Mr. Johnson, you can throw in any song that you feel like, because I need to get a little bit warmer.
Oh, you feel like make a throw in anything where I want? Aye, man. Okay, well, make a find something, make we throw in and this thing. Make we just throw it in, yeah.
Yes.
Okay, give me 1 second right there. We're throwing in. We're cook it. We're store it. And we're take it out. And we're, oh, my goodness gracious.
Oh, the lovely Tanya Carter, you guys.
Yep.
Is on that seat.
All right, then. Okay, yes, yes. I'm still looking for something that I want to hear.
So,
because you kind of put me on my spot there. But we're good.
In the meantime, and in between time, let's shout out some folks online. Dr. Tess, thank you for tuning in. Maria, hello. Thank you for tuning in. Miss Eva, thank you for tuning in. Janet Guzman, good morning, all the way from Florida.
Yeah.
Miss Elaine Proby, let's hear one of the reggae songs. You want to hear one of Tanya's reggae song?
Yeah. All right, so we're going to continue right there, but let me say hi to the folks. We're on simultaneously on YouTube, on Facebook, on Twitch, and on BelizeBix.com. And we have a couple of fellas who said, Tanya, may they sing about me when you talk about ex-boyfriend. Woo! continue fooling yourself, because they're not uno. Ha! That's me! All right, then.
Hey!
listening to A Wake Up Like This on Radio Belize Mix on Twitch, on YouTube, and on BelizeMix.com simultaneously. And we've got a very special guest inside the studio, the one and only lovely lioness, Tanya Carter, and Queen Lerna. Go ahead, Queen Lerna.
Look how he said that, Tanya. What you want to say to him? You understand? Yeah, I know what I'm doing. Let's get him. Will, watch it. You know she wasn't No Matter What.
Oh, yeah, you're right. You're
yes. Right. I told you we're going to go down some rabbit hole. All the way down, you guys. That's why I say multi-talented Tanya Carter is here with us today, you guys. I mean, she's a singer, she's an actress, she do it all, right? And she educated herself within the industry by working with Niche, by working with BMA, by working with the MIAB, which is the Music Industry Association of Belize. So, Tanya.
Yeah, Tanya's, the young lady is well-rounded, no? Mm-hmm.
She's well-rounded. And she have a direction that she wants to go at this point, and she's given us coming back to give us great music. So I'm going to ask you a few questions at this point, Tanya, and we're going to take it from here. So, Miss Busy, if you could change one thing in the music industry, what would you change?
Ooh.
Mm-hmm. These are your wild questions.
Yeah, that is a hard one, but a good one. Mm-hmm. If I could change anything in the music industry, I'm figuring we're talking about Belize, right?
We're talking about Belize and to focus on international, also pulling yourself into that industry.
Mm-hmm. So when it comes down to Belize, I think that we need to be educated. We're not educated. We believe that marketing and advertising is the same thing, which is ridiculous. And then we think that management and agent is the same thing. That's absolutely not. They're all separate entities, and yet Belizean on a whole, they are not. We're not at the point where we know what to do in an artist. And then we have to get international people to come in. And then when they step on our toes, we feel some type of way. When in reality, you know, that's the only way how we will be able to really be economically advanced. You know, for example, I look at some of the biggest acts in Belize, and then you kind of want to ask what they have to show for it. You know, a couple belts or a bag doesn't make any sense to me. But at the same time, we need to understand that there is money there. We believe that money is not there. Like, I remember one time there was a conversation, and realizing that you, especially if it's very, very successful artists that knows what they're doing and business savvy,
mm-hmm.
make the same amount as a lawyer and still be looked down upon. Now, the thing is, why is it? It's because we're not educated about the avenues of where an artist can go, where, as opposed to, although we probably would need the lawyer more, but there is ways of all of us to make money.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I just feel like in the music industry, we need to be more educated, and I would love to see more people take courses upon business management rather than just be somebody's cousin and want to be.
I have to agree, because if you watch these unsung videos about even the artists them out here in the United States, they mm-hmm. were taken advantage of. They were on tours and all that, and when they came back and no money, they have nothing to show for it, because what? They didn't know the business aspect of it. So it's very important that each and every artist learn the business aspect of it, because ultimately that should be the goal, because you should gain something from your talent. Period.
Your talent. Right. It's a business, and very good answer, Tanya. These are things that we need to understand and educate ourselves with. This other question that I want you to, because I know, like I said, I know you worked in all the fields, of these things and department that should help talents. And so I'm asking you this question. I'm not sure if a lot of us know what is the importance of branding yourself, your image out there as an artist, and your brand. So can you tell me your idea of how you go about doing yourself as far as getting yourself out there? Because most people try to depend on others, but I think it's your responsibility.
So when I first came out, I had absolutely no idea of what I was, what I was going to be. I just know I was a cute girl and what could possibly be Tanya's dealer spiel, right? And I remember everybody came to me and said, oh, you're a diva. First of all, I am nothing like a diva, if you would only know. And I'm not saying that to say something negative. They feel as though the confidence that I exude is a diva, which if they only knew I was a tomboy and just, you know, and it stick with me. So every time somebody said that I was a diva, I ran with it. So I went to the company I was with. I'm not calling the name because they're not sponsored.
So I like her business.
I remembered clearly, you know, I said, you know, everybody thinks that I'm a diva, so we're going to run with that. We're going to do a commercial that says Tanya the Diva. And that's what we're going to do. So everything that I did after that time, I made sure that everybody knew that I'm a diva, 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 diva. So the branding in itself was black. Where is she wearing black? How she's going to do her hair? How she's going to do this? How she's going to do that? Because at the end of the day, I wanted whenever you see that, you feel like she's wearing Tanya Carter clothes. I don't want black. I don't own black at all. I don't own the color black.
Right.
But yet every single time an artist would show up with a whole entire black ensemble, they say, why do you wear Tanya Carter clothes? And that's where I think a lot of people have a lot of disconnect with their brand because they don't know which way they're going.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if we want to talk examples of branding, Michael Jackson did the glove, it's over. You can't wear gloves no more. Ariana Grande did the ponytail for a very long time. That was a part of her branding.
Branding.
No, I'm not saying that it's so easy to capture what your brand would be, but you have to know where I'm going with this. What am I setting? What is the example? And my thing was this, even although that I was on the cusp of being toxic, I never wanted to rule out.
She said it.
I never wanted to rule out the kids because that would have been a lot of my money. So I said to myself, I said, this is where we're going to draw the line. I'm not going to cuss in any of my songs.
If
I did make a little bit of a mistake, then I fixed it in the end. But that's where I knew what I wanted to be. I was going to be right dead smack in the middle. I was going to sell out all my merchandise. My merchandise was going to be for kids and for adults so that the picnic, the mom, the granny, the papa, and everybody can wear what Tanya Carter shirt. So that's where I feel like a lot of people just really miss their opportunity because they want to be with the it crowd when they want to lose a big part of the bug. And I learned from Katy Perry. Katy Perry?
Katy.
Mm-hmm. Katy Perry, she is one of the artists. When she came up with I Kissed a Girl and she realized that her revenue just was not matching up. And then when she went into the dark horse and the music where it was Candies and California Girls, she realized that her revenue went up. And it was all because of the children. And I said to myself, I said, wait a minute, I didn't lose our bag because I want no more cussing, no more this, no more that. Because at the end of the day, you have to know, even although we're not just to stick with the money, I'm just giving people example of what you want your business module to be.
To be.
Mm-hmm. And branding is definitely a major part of it because that's where you get into branching out to have merchandise and souvenirs.
Exactly.
You don't want to miss out on the opportunity, no.
So it's very important. Thank you. Thank you, Philip, for that answer. So before we go into another Tanya Carter song, Mr. Johnson, you have that selection that you want to play. I want to say once again, Little Billy's restaurant there in Inglewood is open till 7 p.m. Check us out. Tanya Katza. Mm-hmm.
On the distant horizon, far across the blue, lies a land full of mystery. Feel the warmth of the shining sun. Feel the cool of the breeze. Hear the sound of the rolling wave calling to you and me.
Welcome to Belize.
Welcome to Belize. Land so sweet, paradise waiting for you. Land of rolling green plain, lands of mountains and valleys. Hear the cry of the calling birds, see bright flowers in bloom. Verdant hues of red, green and gold, intoxicating perfume. Feel the warmth of its smiling face, people in harmony. Nowhere else on this earth is found a land so precious and free.
Oh my goodness gracious, my goodness gracious. I love that song, L-O-V-E, with a lot of E behind it. Ooh-wee! Take it away, Queen Lerner.
Okay, doke. Can you hear me, guys?
Yes, we're hearing you, Queen Lerner.
All right. Welcome to Belize. Tanya, I think that song that's way back in 2009. You was only like 16 years old, right?
No.
2009. You were the lead singer on that one, girl. You did a very good job with that song.
Thank you. It was very hard to do, especially back then. You know, when shout out to all the people that were on that We Are Belize project.
Great song.
Frankie Renaud wrote those songs, and you know, he handpicked a bunch of us to do certain songs, but this was his like big song and he knew it. And when he came to me, I never wanted the song at all. I was like, I don't want to do that song. That song hard. And I was defeating myself, and after a while I gone home and cry. And my mom was like, my mom tell me to my face, my mom say, Frankie pick you. Mm-hmm. You have the most faith in you. You have to do a good job. And that kind of like uplift me a little bit. And by the time I gone do the first take, I never feel like I did my best. And then the second take, that's what you guys hear. And I did my best at the time with what I had. So, you know, that really, really shout out to Frankie Renaud and the entire team for allowing me to have one of the biggest songs.
Yes.
In for Belize, you know, so that was amazing.
All right, guys, we're getting so close and we still have a lot to discuss with the lovely Tanya Carter. I'm going to ask you one question and then we'll have another music queue up for you. Let me know one of your best performance or your worst performance. That just... Mm-hmm. We all have one of those. We all have some of those.
Yeah, we do.
We all have some of those.
Performance was in Benquebejo. Probably about maybe 6 years ago, in the middle of my sold out show, blackout gun. And it was so bad because everybody paid their money. I was like, I never knew. It was so bad. It was like, I was there like,
my gosh.
I was like, I don't know what to do, guys. Like, and I was just standing there. And usually I'm very good at segue. I'm very good at that. But I was just so stunned. Like, I look fool. Like, I didn't know what to do. And even although, like, it gone, all the lights gone, you could still see me. You know what I mean?
Oh, my goodness. You just wanted to disappear right there, huh?
It was so embarrassing. Yeah. And it was one of them things where it's inevitable, but still it was a bad taste in a lot of people's mouths. And yeah. Then I'm not in control of any ticket man or people who did the show. They hired me to do a service and I came and whatever. And it was just very ugly at the end of the day. Mm. Best performance, however, have to be best performance.
Come on. All of them then. How about all of
them? No. I mean Kikaka or San Pedro. Every time I do watch a show in Kikaka or San Pedro, and yes, even although Dangriga is second. Uh-huh. Kikaka and San Pedro, that ain't nothing to play. When you hear Tanya Carter, they show up in drones.
Okay.
And I don't know why, but it has happened to me.
That's your happy space.
Yeah.
You're happy to go to Kikaka for performance. So that's good to know. Mr. Johnson, let's get another one of your song in a couple. You have another one, Mr. Johnson? You guys pay attention to these songs.
I'm
Danger.
Now you better run, I'll give you a head start. Cause when I catch you, police can't protect you. Baby, trust me when I say you ain't seen crazy yet. My mama said you were no good. I guess it's all my fault. But let me help you to understand. If I lose it and get my Loretta, the shame on me.
Hey, Miss Lerner, I may have to go for my hammer for me to protect myself because the lady pull out her axe. What axe? Oh my goodness, what axe? Oh my goodness. Take it away, Queen Lerner.
You look close to it, Mr. Johnson. I was scared for a minute. I'm like, what? All right. Congratulations on that one. That was another hit for you, Tanya. Most of your music is very good to listen to, you guys. The message in those songs is very good. And she said she was going through some times in those, but that one right there, oh my goodness, I will be running away from you at that time, at that place.
Yeah, I kind of figured that out after a while. Like, guys used to always be like, man, you're really pretty, but yeah,
you're crazy.
And I'm like, what?